Hello there, welcome back to part two. When I've decided to go back onto that E chord, because I don't think I explained that very well with my fingers going on there. So without further ado, we're going to roll the camera in. And I'm going to try to, let's see, cool. Hang on, it might be a bit close there. Explain a straightforward beat to do that. Going on an E7 chord, remember? So try this on the A string. So we're going from the A string, hitting the G string and the B string together, even if your finger blocks it. It doesn't matter if you hear it open like this. You go on the A string, G and B. So try doing it as a beat first, like this one, and them two together. If you can get that going, now as you can hear that, I am blocking the B string there, letting me hand just relax on it. So it doesn't matter either way if you hear it. Doing that and two together. Now we're going to split these two like this. So you get this. See the second one? I split it. First one, second one. And with the third finger, we can catch the bottom string like this. So you go on from there using those two. Then, this one and that one for the bottom. Another way, those two for the bottom two. See, same as we say in Liverpool, same dance. Right round, so you can see the fingers going in there. That's it. All you got to do then is slide this finger into the 8th fret and back. Looks like this. Now that's probably the best I can do with explaining that E, because actually what happens is I just hit it like and don't really think about it. So I get a blend of notes as I'm going along, sort of like this. Go in and take a look at this chord. What we're playing here, an A minor chord at the 5th fret. So we've got that A minor chord. And what we're going to do, we're going to hit it once like that, push our finger, elbow forward, hear the difference in the sound, because that allows you to lift this finger and release those two bottom strings so that they sound open like this. And that, when you pick a note, comes out like this. There's the A minor. Again, we're using the thumb, those two fingers. Yeah, see that? So it's gone from the D to the G with your thumb. And notice the way it splits the second time. Split it the first time as well, providing you it with that finger first. See? So you can see how I'm pushing elbow forward, brings the hand up like that. So, from the beginning. Because we've gone from the A minor now, bringing the A7 into play, simple D7. Let's have a look at that played with this hand. So we come all the way around. So I go, and that's. Take it away again. This is the D7. So I'm removing that third finger, this one here. Try again. Now you can start messing around with it now. And this is the next bit we're going into in the next one. Now, I think that's not a bad little effort, that. I hope that it helps you out. And remember, give generously if you can. Catch you later.